The speedometry curriculum has been designed using the 5E model of instruction. The 5Es stand for engage, explore, explain, elaborate, and evaluate. So let's dig into these 5Es. Kids cannot learn if they're not engaged. The speedometry curriculum uses excellent videos with kids actually seeing real cars scaled up going down ramps to get their attention and noticing phenomena that they're going to ask questions about. The engage is so important in the 5E model to assess prior knowledge of students and also to use the experience from the engage to come up with scientifically oriented questions that they will then investigate as we move to the next phase. The next phase is the explore phase. Here is an opportunity for the kids to work together to have a shared experience around the scientific phenomena that they're investigating. The data that students collect here and the observations and conclusions that they draw from the explore is what you bring into the explain phase. An important part of doing science is that the explain comes after the initial explore. So now that your kids have explored a scientific phenomena, you can now as the teacher facilitate learning during this explain phase. This is the time to introduce the scientific vocabulary, any particular skills in mathematics, any formats that you would want to follow in terms of literacy skills and lab reports. The explain phase is very important in helping kids make connections between the explore and the scientific vocabulary. The fourth E is called elaboration. This is a very important phase in teaching and learning. This gives kids an opportunity to apply what they've learned to a new context. And that gives kids an opportunity to dig deeper into the content and then to apply their learning to some new context. The fifth and final E is the evaluation stage. The speedometry curriculum allows kids to assess their own learning as they've created models and revised their models to explain the scientific phenomena, and you as a teacher to understand through the use of looking at the students' projects and their presentations what they've learned in terms of the math skills, the literacy skills, and the science skills and concepts that this curriculum has been designed around. Do you have any questions about the 5E model?
Yes, I have a large classroom, and I'm just concerned about during the explore stage, how do you deal with so many children during that phase of the 5Es?
I think the speedometry curriculum is engaging curriculum, and when kids are engaged, they'll stay on task. We've also suggested group structures and group roles so that every student knows what they're responsible for doing throughout the lesson. But again, the most important thing in learning is engagement.
As you know, as a teacher, we always have a lot of things going on. What if I run out of time? Can I skip steps of the 5E model, and how will that impact the units?
Skipping one of the 5Es is not recommended. All phases of the 5E model are important for student learning. We have to first start with an engage so the kids can connect the material to their lives. Kids need to learn to do science and ask questions, and this curriculum allows kids to do that. In the era of next-gen standards and Common Core, there are going to be fewer topics to study. So I think this curriculum is going to allow the depth of understanding that kids truly need to understand science and engineering practices, as well as integrating in literacy opportunities and mathematical skills.
Will this work for all the different types of kids in my classroom?
Inquiry-based approaches to learning allow the teacher to put students in groups where there's many more opportunities to differentiate learning. Kids can help each other, teacher acts as facilitator, and truly you're the one that knows your students. So we recommend that you take this curriculum and really understand this 5E model and make it work for your students.